An important new study released just this Thursday entitled The Obama Administration and the Press, Leak Investigations and Surveillance in Post-9/11 America has hit, and everybody's taken notice, certainly in the journalism community. The author, Len Downie, former executive editor of The Washington Post and professor of journalism at the Cronkite School at the ASU, Arizona State University, is here. What did you find?
I found that in several ways the administration is making it very difficult for reporters to hold it accountable for the actions of its government, particularly in the national security area, but throughout the rest of the government as well, in several ways. First of all, there have been all these leaks investigations, including the number of prosecutions, 8 prosecutions under a 1917 Espionage Act that was enacted for spying for foreign enemies that prosecuted government officials who provided information to the press. And in addition, lots of other leaks investigations that are going on that even produce prosecutions that are making government officials afraid to talk to reporters. I interviewed dozens of reporters in Washington who told and other government accountability people who told me that government officials are afraid to talk to them.
And to be clear about it, you and I spoke as well.
Yes.
You even quote me in here. I think I made some sense. The point I was making was that in some of the ways that the administration goes to the public on its own.
Yes.
Openness is good. They
Right.
promised openness. But if taken too far, that can become a slippery slope to spin and even worse.
Yes. The president promised to be going to have the most transparent government in American history. And the way they've interpreted that is to use social media and websites in ways that you said to present lots of information that makes the administration look good and other information that's useful to consumers and businesses and so on. But at the same time, they've really shut the door on a lot of the reporting that's necessary to hold the administration accountable by journalists.
You've been in this town a long time, and here's part of what you wrote in this report. The administration's war on leaks, you called it, and other efforts to control information are the most aggressive I've seen since the Nixon administration, when I was one of the editors involved in the Washington Post investigation of Watergate. That's a very strong allegation, Len Downie.
Well, it's what I heard from everyone that I interviewed here in Washington, and not many of them are as old as I am and go all the way back to the Nixon administration, but in their memories, the time they've been working here, this is the most close administration that they've encountered.
Now, I want to push back a little bit because there will be some who say, look, if the administration is clamping down on leakers who would deal with sensitive Right. information, national security secrets, they should be doing that.
Right. Well, first of all, some of this was clearly whistleblowing about problems, for instance, in the NSA surveillance program long before the revelations of Edward Snowden. These are people you would want to call whistleblowers. But the administration seems to make a distinction between what they say is whistleblowing or information about bureaucratic waste and abuse and information that's about government programs and government actions that the American people should know about. Many of these secret programs are not in the revelations do not endanger national security. Instead, they bring about the kind of public debate that's necessary.
One of the other things you point out is the increase in secrecy over the past several years. The report cites that by 2011, more than 4 million Americans,
That's right.
4 million Americans had security clearance.
Yes, and as a result, way too much information is overclassified, so that it's almost difficult for a government official to talk to a reporter about anything that isn't classified. And the president promised again, at the beginning of his administration, that he was going to reduce this overclassification of government administration. There's been a commission from Congress that made recommendations to the president and went specific ways to reduce it, and none of that action's taken place yet.
You quoted David Sanger, terrific reporter with the New York Times. A memo went out from the chief of staff a year ago to White House employees, he told you, and the intelligence agencies that told people to freeze and retain any email and presumably phone logs of communications with me.
This is the other problem with these leaks investigations, whether or not they result in prosecutions, is that there's been a lot of going through the communications records of reporters and their sources in government. And that really does have a chilling effect. So reporters are telling me their sources don't want to talk to them on the telephone. They don't want to talk to them by email. And not just about classified information, about anything. They only want to meet secretly if they want to meet at all. It's made it very, very difficult to do reporting. But these are knowledgeable government officials who can help reporters out. You had a story earlier on this program about a problem with the New York Times story.
Which I'm going to ask
The problem is, if you can't talk to the knowledgeable government officials, then you're working around the edges with people that may not be so knowledgeable.
Recommendations in this report for the government.
Yes, well, first of all, to reduce overclassification is the president's promise, but not carried out. To make it easier to get information through the Freedom of Information Act, which the president promised but has not yet done. And to tell government officials that you can talk directly to the press. You don't have to go through the press officers all the time, get their permission, or have to actually send the reporters to the press officers. Let knowledgeable officials talk to the press.
And I want to be clear here. You are not saying, and the report is not calling for more leaks of sensitive information that would endanger national security. You understand that.
Yes.
We all understand that. You got requests yourself not to report certain things.
Yes.
And you sat on those stories?
We didn't sit on the stories. That's usually not what takes
sometimes.
Place. It's usually details within them.
Mm-hmm.
Locations of things, names of things, things like that, as opposed to the fact that a certain program is going on that the American people should know about.
Before I let you go, I do want to talk to you, since you were executive editor at the Washington Post, about what we were talking about earlier with the New York Times. Three very serious stories, either getting it wrong or getting parts of it wrong in just 8 days. A black eye.
Well, these things can happen, and particularly if the administration is not being very cooperative with the press, it's hard to get things
accurate. Oh, you're going to blame it on the administration?
Well, that's part of it. But in terms of the Times, I don't know the exact facts of them. I don't want to sit in judgment of their editorial decisions. But what I can say is that it's important to be transparent. This report is about being the government being transparent. The news media needs to be transparent, too. So if you make a mistake, you need to acknowledge your mistake and describe, you know, why did that happen? And in the case of the first two things that you cited, they changed the stories without ever explaining why they changed the stories.
And they should have done that.
And it seems to me you should be transparent about that.
I wish they had joined us here today to explain what went wrong and how they make these choices. I think the biggest issue for people and for most who would read this is these officials say. I think that's one of the big things that we all fight, right?
Yes, but again, it's up to the administration to allow people to talk on the record, and it's up to reporters to be aggressive about seeking that.
Len Downie, as always, thank you so much. Thanks for the report, and thanks for coming by.
Thank you, Frank.
Thanks for being transparent.
Thank you.